hair is raised just a little bit. He's trying to decide what he should do. I was trying to block him off. Here we go. Here we go. I'm going to try to strike. And when he does, I'm well, this may be just... You see the posture of the other dog? He's not moving. He's not following into that threat. He's just freezing, allowing for him to check him out. Fantastic. So I didn't have to correct him. I didn't have to correct him. That's a good sign. It's a good sign. See the hair up on the other dog? He knows that there's a possibility of a problem. We're just waiting. That's good. That's what we're looking for. You say, okay, check me out. Check me out. Fantastic. That's a good start. That's a really good start. Now, in using the muzzle, of course, it allows us to get very close so that our reflexes are not off, so that we don't jump the gun. So we'll see what a dog will do naturally. Some people think that the muzzle will create stress, but when a dog is focused on another dog, the focus is on that dog alone. So the muzzle really doesn't have an effect until after the dog walks away or turns his head away and realizes at that time that he has the muzzle on. So now we're going to release a dog that is still intact. And let's see how that affects this man.